So in this demonstration, we are going to understand how we can create an EXE for Netcat. To do this, we need some tools, and the required tools are, we need to have a Visual Studio, developer command prompt. You can use any other IDEs as well, and you can build an EXE file, but Visual Studio command prompt helps you write a program and compile it quickly and convert it into an EXE file. To do this, I have Visual Studio installed, and I'm going to use my developer command prompt for Visual Studio 2012. Let's run this program as an administrator. And what we'll do, within our machine, I'm going to create this program within a directory, Ethical Hacking Training 2. So I'll go to my directory, Ethical Hacking Training 2, and within this, we are going to create a program. And let's say I want to create a program which can start Netcat for me. To do this, I'm going to write a program, let's say notepad virus.c. Let's press enter and we are going to write a program. So here what we can do is, we can quickly write a program and let's just increase the size. So we are going to write a simple program. We are going to include stdio.h. We are going to include standard library light.h. Then what we'll do, we're going to write a main function. Within this main function, since it's an integer function, we are going to return 0. And what we want, we are going to execute a system command. And using the system command, we are going to write the code nc.exe hyphen, let's say we are going to create a connection to 192.168.1.20 or 16, that's my machine, on its port number 6789, and we are going to bind our command prompt. Okay. Before this, we can do it something like this. We can execute a printf statement and let's say software project. Let's say do it something like download in progress or something in order to fool a user that something is happening. So he may wait for some time before closing the program. Until that time, you will be able to execute that. You'll get access to shell and you can do whatever you want till that time. So let's just save it. Now what we'll do, we'll go to the developer command prompt again, and using this CL command, which stands for compile and link, we can compile this program virus.c into an exe file. So as soon as we do that, you can see that we have got a virus.exe. Now what we can do is, let's say within our ethical hacking directory, you can see that we have got a virus.exe program. We can take the combination of this virus.exe and nc, and we can send it to a friend. So what we can do, let's say here within my application, I have this nc. Let me just copy that. Let me just paste that here. Either I can execute or archive it in something like self-extractable exe. Okay. We can do it something like this, create an self-executable file SFX archive, or what we can do is, within the advanced section, we are going to modify SFX options. So generally we can see in which path we have to extract that. We can go to setup, and after execution we are going to execute virus.exe, and now wait and return exit code, and we can do something like this. Let's put in OK. Let's create OK, and now an exe file has been generated, and this exe file can be transmitted to a user and he'll be able to run it. Program will get extracted, virus.exe will execute, and it will use that nc.exe which is available in the same directory, and the commands will execute. So we'll perform the demo in the next session.